Saira, yes, children. I think you all are enjoying at home with your mommy, daddy, brother, sister, right? Now it's more than 1 month that you are enjoying, okay? And by sitting at home, you are able to learn also, right? Learn what is being taught in the school, right? Yes, children. Yes, you are able to view and listen to what is being taught. Okay, very good, children. So that means you all are not missing your studies. You are continuing with your studies as well as you are able to enjoy at home. Both the things are happening, right? Okay, children. Now, children, this is our fourth EVS period. Which period? Fourth EVS, that is environmental studies. In this fourth period, we are going to learn chapter 4. That means we have already completed three chapters. The first chapter is about me, second one is my body, third one is, what is the third chapter? Do you all remember the third chapter, children? Yes or no? My body helps me. And the third, fourth chapter is my body needs care. My body needs care. See, you already know about the first chapter about me. I did not tell you. Okay. I think you are well aware of that. The second chapter is my body. That means the various parts of the body. I had explained to you in detail the various parts of the body, right from the head to toe. And the second chapter, we had learned how these various parts are useful to us in our day-to-day activities. How do we use our hands, legs, nose, eyes, ears, teeth, legs in our day-to-day activities? Am I right, children? Should I explain to you once how it is useful? Okay, in brief, I'll just tell you. Okay, listen attentively. You hear with your ears, see with your eyes, smell with your nose, taste with your tongue, write with your hands, draw with your hands, then clap with your hands. Yes or no? Then what else you do? What else you do? Eat with your hands. The same way with legs, what you do? Run with the help of your legs. Skip with the help of your legs. Kick with the help of your legs. Jump with the help of your legs. So, these are the activities which are being done with the help of the various parts of the body. And I had already taught you the five sense organs. That is, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue form part of the face, whereas skin form part of the whole body. This all you all know very well. I think already I had explained to you in brief about this in the last chapter. Now, in the chapter 4, what we are going to learn? Okay, in chapter 4, what we are going to learn is my body needs care. See, you have to take care of your body also. It is your duty to take care of your body. Nobody help, others will not help you. But you yourself have to take care of your body. How you are going to take care? Let us see now. Okay, how you will take care? Eat well, healthy food, eat healthy food, drink plenty of water, have good sound sleep, take rest, do proper exercises. These are the things which need to be taken into account while taking care of your body. You have to take care of your body by eating good healthy food, drinking plenty of water, and having proper sleep. And now let us see step by step how we are going to take care of your body. Children, you are not feeling bored. Are you listening to my lecture children. Yes, are you all enjoying? I hope you all are enjoying, children. Yes, now look at the screen. Okay, have a smiling face. Okay, the fourth chapter is My Body Needs Care. My body needs care. That is, you need to take care of your body. Let us see how you are going to take care. Look at this picture on the screen. What this girl is doing? She is brushing her teeth. She is brushing her teeth with the help of a toothbrush. With the help of a toothbrush. The second picture, the boy is having bath, is taking bath. Can you see that? Yes, is pouring water on his body with the help of a mug. The third picture, he is wearing a shirt or some jacket like. Yes, after taking bath, he is wearing a fresh cloth. Now, after that, you can see this girl combing hair. After wearing dresses and all, she is combing her hair so that it will look neat and clean. After that, this girl, what is she doing? She is having her breakfast. I suppose it is chapati or something, right? With some gravy, sabji. She is having a breakfast, sitting in the table, dining table, and she is enjoying a breakfast. Then after that, she is drinking water. She is drinking water. See, when you are having your meal or lunch, in between you are not supposed to drink water. Only after you complete eating, then only you can drink water. Now, this boy, what is he doing? He's playing. He's doing exercise. That is, in the evening, he's going out to play in the ground. See, you can see, he's playing football. You can see the football over there, right? And after that, after doing all the activities, that is right from the morning till evening, they have finished all their activities. After finishing all their activities, you go to sleep. Because you need rest also. Am I right? Whole day you are busy studying, going to school, then doing exercises, then everything you are doing. No? So your body needs rest also. How you will get rest? Only by having a proper sound sleep. And that is very, very necessary to have a proper sleep. Now, we have seen with how to take care of your body. Right? Now, let us see what this boy is going to tell you. Just listen carefully. He is going to tell you in step by step again how to take care of your body. See what he is telling. What is the first sentence here? To clean my teeth, I use a toothbrush. That is what you do to take care of your teeth. You use a toothbrush and a toothpaste also. Both is required. Not only toothbrush, toothpaste is also required to clean your teeth. Then, when my hair is untidy, I use a comb. That is, when your hair is untidy, to make it neat, like presentable, you use a comb and then you tie your hair. Yes or no? I think girls, everybody knows that. You then tie two ponies. Your mommy nicely, she ties for you two ponies when you come to school. No, so it looks neat. Then you look smart also. When my hands are dirty, I wash them with soap. See, always you have to wash your hands after playing, after coming from the school, or after playing from the, after you come from the ground, after playing, you have to wash your hands. After going to the washroom, you have to wash your hands. See, this hygiene you need to be followed. I will tell you how it is to be followed. See, if you will not wash your hands, what will happen, you know? The dirt in your hand will go inside the stomach. How it will go inside the stomach? Tell me. You eat with a dirty hand. So along with the food, the dirt also enters your stomach. Then you get stomach pain. Then you say, ah, mummy, my stomach is paining. Then mummy, what she will do? She will take you to the doctor. Then doctor will give you medicine. Again, you feel like you don't like to take that sour medicine. You will say, mama, I don't want medicine. Then somehow your mummy will give you medicine. She will mix it with honey and she will give you the medicine. Then only you will be all right. So always remember, neatly you have to wash your hands. You have to wash your hands with soap. Understood? Before eating, after eating, after coming from the school, after you come from, in the evening you go out to play and when you come, no, again you have to wash your hands and legs. So please see to it, you maintain proper hygiene. Cleanliness is very much essential to take care of your body. Are you able to get my point, children? Yes. Are you enjoying? Okay. Now, nails. All of you look at your nails. Whether your nails have grown. Usually teacher checks in the school, no, whether the nails have grown. Am I right? Now you are going to check whether the nails have grown. If it has grown, tell your mama, mummy, please cut my nails. Please cut my nails. It is too long. Please cut my nails. Why the nails should be cut? Tell me now again. It is the same reason. That is, what happens when the nails grow, dirt goes inside the nails. You just see, scratch your head, you play with something like, so all the dirts go inside the nail. Again with the same hand, you eat your food. The dirt again enters your stomach. Again there is a problem in the stomach. Again you get stomach pain, then again you take medicine. So it continues. To avoid all this, you need to cut your nails regularly. With what you will cut your nails? When my nails are too long, I use a nail cutter to cut them. That your mummy will do. Slowly she will hold your finger like this and slowly she will cut your nail. You will not have any pain. Okay? Now see to it that your nails are not grown. If it is grown, tell your mama to cut your nails. Okay, children? Okay. I know you all are very smart. You listen to teacher. Yes? Okay. Now, when I have a cold, I use a handkerchief. See, again, this is very, very important. When you cough or when you sneeze, what happens? The saliva, it comes like, it spreads, comes out. So always you have to use a handkerchief. So that when you keep an handkerchief, it will go inside the handkerchief only. It will not come out. So if somebody is standing beside you and when you cough or when you sneeze, what happened? It comes out. So it is not good. Then again the cold will spread to the others also. So to take care of that, you have to keep a handkerchief like this and then cough like this. Okay? While sneezing also, what you will do? You will keep the handkerchief like this and then sneeze. Am I right, children? Yes, otherwise the germs will spread and your friends will also get the cold. So to avoid that, always keep a handkerchief. And even the handkerchief should be neat. It should not be a dirty handkerchief. You have to wash your handkerchief daily. And fold it neatly. Keep it in your pant pocket or in the bag while coming to school. Okay? And you have to hold it like this and then only you have to cough. Okay? Yes. These are the personal hygiene which needs to be followed. When I am wet, I use a towel to dry myself. Let us suppose, see, when you wash your face, you have your bath, and when you come out from the rain, what happened? No, rainy season is going to come. When you come inside the house, what happened? You are wet, totally wet. So what you will do? You have to take a wet towel, not wet towel, you will take a dry towel. Wet also okay, it should not be too much, but little bit is okay. A dry towel you will take and then you will wipe your body. Okay, then you will wipe your body. Then it will become dry. Okay, children, again, the towel should be neat and clean. It should not be a dirty towel. Daily you have to wash the towel also. So, we have seen how to keep your body clean. That is the way, what care you have to take to keep yourself neat and clean. Now, let us see what is this picture over here, comb. As I told you, we will comb your hair with the help of a comb and brush your teeth with the help of the toothbrush. Towel. You will wipe your body with the help of a towel. Yes, and this is a handkerchief. As I told you, when you get cold or when you sneeze, always keep a handkerchief in front of the mouth and then only you will cough. Nail cutter. You would have seen a nail cutter. See, for small children, you get small nail cutter so that it will be easy for you to cut your nails. And this is what? Soap. You dry your body with the help of dry your body with the help of towel and wash your hands and body with the help of soap. Yes, children? Okay. Now, we have seen how we have to take care of your body. Now see, again all of you just listen to what I have told you. I will explain to you again how to take care of your body. Now tell me, what will happen if you grow your nails? I told you, the dirt will go inside. When you eat, the dirt will go inside the stomach. Right? And again, you have to wash your hands before and after the meal. That is, wash your hands before you eat. Before and after you eat, after you have to wash your hands. Then you have to brush your teeth twice a day, early in the morning and before going to bed. Both the times you have to wash your hands. Because see, early in the morning too you are doing. But before going to bed, you have to do, because the whole day, throughout the day, you have been eating something, you have been having your breakfast, lunch, dinner. So all the food particles will get collected in your mouth, near the teeth. So if you not brush your teeth, it will remain in the teeth only. And you will get cavities. Again, your teeth will start paining. You will get toothache. Again, you have to go to the doctor. No? So to avoid this, you have to brush your teeth twice a day, early in the morning and before going to bed. And children, you have to, eating time should be proper. Breakfast you should have at the proper time, lunch in the proper time, then whatever snacks if you are going to have in the evening, that also at the proper time, and dinner also at the proper time. It should not be very late also. You cannot have dinner at 10:30, 11 at night, no. By 8:30, you should finish your dinner so that the digestion will be proper. So by 8:30, if you have your dinner, 8:30, you can go to bed by 10 o'clock. Then you can wake up in the morning, early morning by 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock, and you can get ready to go to school. That means if you have morning school, you have to wake up early in the morning, right? So, even otherwise, the dinner you should have on proper time. Same way, lunch also, by 1 o'clock in the afternoon, you should have your lunch. Breakfast also, try to have before 9 or 8:30. So, this is the ideal timing. These timings you have to follow. So, and not only that, you need to have proper sleep. At least 8 hours sleep you should have. Okay? That means proper sleep and proper rest. After the entire whole day activities, you need to have rest. All your body parts become very tired. You also become tired and your body parts will also start paining. So for that, you need to have proper rest and proper sleep. And to be healthy and fit, you need to do exercises. The last chapter, that is chapter 3, my body helps me, no? Dad had told you what are the exercises to be done, like running, skipping, cycling, swimming. These exercises are very good, children. You can go in the evening. I think you all may be having your garden or something. There you can go for 10-15 minutes. You can jog. And if you have cycle for half an hour, you can ride the cycle. I mean, inside your building only. And girls can do skipping also. Skipping is a very good exercise. And you all know, skipping needs the help of, exercise needs the help of both your hands and legs. Cycling also, you need the help of both hands and legs. I had taught you in the previous chapter. That is cycling, swimming, and what else? Cycling, swimming, and skipping. These three exercises needs the help of both hands and legs. So exercise is a must. You all are growing children. So, and your body is very flexible. Anyway, you can twist your body. So this is the age how you have to take care of your body. So proper exercise is very much necessary. So when you grow big, you will have the stamina. See, proper exercise will make you fit. You will be able to write. You will be able to concentrate in the class. Otherwise, what happens when there is no body movements? Always you sit and watch TV. What will happen? Your legs and hands will not work only. You will be only used to seeing TV, that's all. So once if teacher tells you to write, you will say, my hands are paining. Because there is no movements in the hands. Right? Legs are paining. When you walk, you will say, my legs are paining. Because you are not doing exercises. So daily if you do exercises, it will become, what happened? It will become fit. You will be able to maintain your body properly. Fit. You will be fit and fine. So to be fit and fine, you have to eat healthy food. That is also very important. Healthy food and no junk food. Healthy, that is leafy vegetables, fruits, and drink plenty of water. You need to drink plenty of water, especially in summer season now. Because what happens? You perspire. So when you perspire, see the water comes out like all that. So again, you have the body needs water, no? So for that, you need to drink more of water. So to avoid any further this, you have to drink plenty of water. Water is very much essential to the body, especially in summer season. Especially in summer season. The water contents from the body goes out through the perspiration. So again, you have to drink water to maintain the water level in the body. So drink plenty of water and not cold water. Not from the fridge. You should drink ordinary water, filter water. Don't drink directly cold water. I know some children, after they come out from the this thing, after playing, when they come to the house, what they do, come home, they from the fridge they take and drink water. Like this, they will drink. That you should not do. Understood? You should wait, sit for some time. And you should have plain water only, not cold water. If you drink cold water, again you will get cold, catch cold. Again you have to go to doctor. Right? So, to avoid all this, you need to be very careful. Sit for some time, relax, and then only you should drink water. And water also, you should sit and drink, not standing, not in the standing position. Sit in one place, take 5 minutes rest, then only you should drink water. You should not drink water fast like. So what happened, it will get stuck up again. Again, you will get cough. Yes, children, you all may be wondering why this teacher is telling again and again this. But these points you have to remember. See, these wrong things, many of the children they do. So at least you see to it, henceforth you don't do all these such things. Okay, that means what you have to see now? What you have to listen now? What did you listen now? Eat on time. Take your breakfast on time. Have your breakfast on time. Eat your lunch on time. Then have your snacks on time. And eat your dinner on time. This is very important. That punctuality is very important in your life. You should always maintain this. Any time of the day you should not eat. Okay? That is not good for health. Proper timings you have to keep. And you should sit and eat. You should enjoy. That is, you should relish your food and eat. That also you should not eat fast. Sit in a place, that is, sit down or sit on the dining table and eat, bite or chew the food and eat. Then only it will get digested. Fast food, you should not gulp the food. Understood? And while eating, again, you will not drink water. Only after you finish eating, you can drink water. In between your meals or lunch, don't drink water. After you finish eating, then you can drink water. So, these are the points which needs to be taken care to maintain a fit and healthy lifestyle. Okay? And see, before I end up with this, let me tell you a small song, this poem. I think you would have already learned this poem. I am sure you all may be knowing this poem. I'll just tell you, because when I sing a poem or something, I know you all enjoy. But every time repeating the same thing, eyes, nose, ears, parts of the body, you feel bored. Am I right? My teacher is telling every time this only. I want some change. You will think like that. Yes? Now, I will tell you a small poem. Listen to this. This is the way we brush our teeth, brush your teeth, brush your teeth. This is the way we brush your teeth early in the morning. This is the way we take a bath, take a bath, take a bath. This is the way we take a bath early in the morning. This is the way we wear our clothes, wear our clothes, wear our clothes. This is the way we wear our clothes early in the morning. This is the way we comb our hair, comb our hair, comb our hair. This is the way we comb our hair early in the morning. This is the way we go to school, go to school, go to school. This is the way we go to school early in the morning. Did you all like this poem? See, here you can add many more things. Like you can say, this is the way we come out of school, come out of school, come out of school. This is the way we come out of school early in the morning. You can say that also. This is the way we eat our lunch, eat our lunch, eat our lunch. This is the way we eat our lunch early in the morning. So, this all you can add. This is just something like for a change. I just told you this poem. This is what, how you have to maintain this is how you have to take care of your body. This is in the form of a poem. In the form of a poem. Did you all enjoy this poem, children? Yes? Can you remember this poem? What teacher taught you today? Yes? Okay. Now we have completed 4 chapters in EVS. How many chapters? 4 chapters, children, remember. Sitting at home, you are able to see, learn and view all these 4 chapters. I think you all are enjoying the schooling from home. I really think you all are enjoying. So, thanks for listening to my lesson. Thank you, children. Thank you very much. Stay safe at home. Have a nice day. Take care of your health. Bye-bye, children. Thank you. Bye.